I don't know. Do you think she survived?
Hi, I'm Carlton Cuse.
And I'm Meredith Averill.
And we're here to break down that crazy ending of season two.
Who are you?
He throws her down the well, and I think he dropped her on her head. I don't know. Do you think she survived?
No. It wasn't good for poor Eden, sadly, but that doesn't sound good for the show in general. I mean, Gideon out there, portal creator, big bad guy.
And we see him use the Anywhere Key and escape into Matheson. So this guy is out there and he has a long history with the Locke family. So something tells me he is going to be out for them in season three.
That would make our stand here.
Dodge is someone who was okay to take her time. She had a lot of patience. She kind of was playing the long game, but Gideon is a fist. He is just all brute strength. He has no patience for anyone. So things are going to heat up very quickly in season three. Dodge is dead, but this is also a show about magic.
So that means we might see more of Dodge in season three?
I think never say never.
No.
Having Lucas back in the show is a way to kind of round out some of the mythology and hopefully answer some questions that the audience might have about, the history of the show and these characters. And, you know, we feel like everybody's curious to know where the keys came from, who's had them before, what they've done before, what their origins are, and we try to explain even more of that in season three.
Well, what we've established is that when a demon is inhabiting a person, there is still a small piece of that human soul that is kind of trapped inside there. And so there was always a little bit of Lucas inside of Dodge. So when he finally gets released, it is kind of this nice sort of end for Lucas's story that he gets to be released from that prison of having been trapped inside Dodge for all those years. In terms of what her experience was like being on that other side, that's something we get to reveal in season three. So I don't want to say too much about, but there will be answers, and we're thrilled to be able to have Sherry Somm back in our show because she's so terrific.
Do I have to? I won't let you.
Yeah, there's a really complicated relationship between Bode and Nina in season three, and we just felt like it was time for Jackson to not just be the sweet, energetic boy that we've seen the whole time. He's getting older, and we wanted to dimensionalize him as a character. And so there's a bunch of new stuff between him and Nina, and dare say there may be some magic involved as well that might influence that storyline. I would say one of the things I'm really excited about for season three is the journey for Tyler, and it turns out to be maybe both a literal and a metaphoric journey. You know, that character is very shattered from the death of Jackie, and that manifests itself in some really interesting ways. And so watching Tyler's journey across the course of season three is really one of my favorite parts of the show.
I would say episode 8 is a good one because you're seeing Gideon's character for the first time in episode 1, but you really get to meet him and see what a badass guy he is in episode 8 in full display. And there's also some other characters within those scenes that you'll see pop back up in season 3. But I think because he is our ultimate villain kind of going into season 3, it's probably great to really focus on him as you're seeing those scenes in episode 8.